Chapters 12 and 14 are about the resources you bring to the business and the resources you need to launch it successfully. And it's not just about money. We deal with this really quite well in chapter 14. The main resource that you bring to the business is you. So in chapter 13, we look at your entrepreneurial leadership skills. And the main resource you will need is people, and in particular, a good management team around you. They will actually make your plans into reality. And this is what we look at in chapter 12. Greiner's growth model, shown in figure 12.1, is about the typical problems that an entrepreneur will face as the business grows. Problems revolving around leadership, developing and controlling a management team, and finally, just how to stay entrepreneurial as a business. Recruiting a good management team is vital if you want the business to grow. You can't do everything yourself. They need to have the appropriate blend of commercial skills, but also the personal character traits, so that they will work effectively as a team. Chapter 12 will show you what these are. And remember, your team can include partners, advisors, investors, and your board of directors, so you don't actually have to own all your resources. To keep your business entrepreneurial, you need to make your approach to leadership consistent with the culture and structure of your organization, not to mention the strategies that you follow. It's called the organizational architecture. But consistency is not enough. An entrepreneurial organization needs to encourage creativity and innovation. Creativity is fostered through giving staff greater autonomy and empowering them to do the things that need to be done by getting them to believe in what they're doing, giving them a purpose. But you still need to control the business, so holding people accountable for their actions is vital. And what about that young apprentice operating a lathe? They need to be told precisely what to do, otherwise they might get hurt. So the key is designing structures within structures that can reconcile the need for different types of control for different types of employees and different types of operations. Chapter 14 focuses on how you need to develop to become an entrepreneurial leader. You need to be a strategic thinker, able to reflect and learn from situations. You need to become an authentic leader, true to yourself, emotionally intelligent, self-aware, and able to manage your own emotions. It's also about being visionary, having a vision about what you want the business to become, being a transformational leader, wanting to make the organization what it can become, and encouraging dispersed leadership among your staff. But at the same time, you've got to be able to adapt your leadership style to particular staff, tasks, and situations. In my view, becoming a great entrepreneurial leader means that you've got to have a vision about where the business will be in 5 to 10 years' time. You've got to be a good communicator and motivator so that that vision is communicated to your staff. You've got to be a great strategic thinker and learning with strong interpersonal skills that enables you to build those relationships which are vital for the success of the business. You've got to be a team player. You need a team to make your business grow. It isn't something you can do on your own. You've got to be a confidence builder. You've got to build confidence within the team that you can take them through this uncertainty. And you've got to build an open organization that shares information. Information is the key to reducing the risks that you face. You've got to be able to focus on the things that are really important and clarify ambiguity and uncertainty. If you can't do it, then the rest of your staff are going to find it very difficult to do that. But probably the main thing you've got to do is to build those empowering opportunities within your staff so that they know the right things to do, when to do them, without being told. And that is really the hallmark of a great entrepreneurial leader.